Welcome to the live session of Mumbai Fashion Week. Today, Dr. Sneha Tulsiani will be joining us for this session before her watercolor masterclass. I'm just waiting for her to join. Hi, Sneha.
Hi, Manshi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
All good.
Is
Yeah,
it clear?
I'm good.
Everything?
Yeah?
Okay. Is everything clear?
Okay. Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so let me start by talking about Mumbai Fashion Week. Mumbai Fashion Week is an organization dedicated to elevate the influence of fashion in India, especially prioritizing the emergence of Mumbai as one of the leading fashion capitals in the world. Hi guys, welcome to this live session. Today we have Dr. Sneha Tulsiani with us. She is a pediatric dentist and also a fashion illustrator. Thank you for joining us, Sneha. We're glad to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so let's start. Can you tell us something about your journey in the fashion illustration?
So I started fashion illustrations like around 3 to 4 years ago. Actually, I'm not a completely professional in fashion illustrations. I started this as a hobby. And I am a dentist by profession. That's why the doctor there. So I practice dentistry as well. And I do fashion illustrations whenever I'm free. Like, I like art. So I do this when in my free time, basically.
Oh, so this is like completely based on your interest.
Yes. It's not a, it's okay. Yet not a profession.
Okay, so we all know you're also a dentist and an illustrator. How do you manage like both the things? And what do you think, like what are the challenges you face like balancing both these things together?
The main thing is time. So whenever it's a, you know, most of the days it's a hectic routine. Because I work around like for 12 hours, at least 12 to 14 hours with dentistry. So, yeah. I do this whenever I have the free time or on weekends. So basically now weekends are not weekends. It is either doing fashion illustrations or something else related to that. So it's not Sunday.
Yeah.
It's a working Sunday.
But with lockdown, every day has become like a weekend and every day is also a working day.
Yeah. So now in the lockdown, I have got a lot of time. I had got a lot of time. That's why I was able to give so much of time to art, basically.
Can you tell us something about your clientele and how do you like reach out to brands and all?
Reaching out to brands, actually I've never done that personally. I have messaged one or two brands, but those are not fashion brands. Those are certain beauty product brands or something like that, to collaborate with them for some customized illustrations and all. But when I've worked with designers, is that they have contacted me after seeing my profile on the Instagram page.
Okay, so it's mostly everything through Instagram.
Yeah, it started through Instagram only. Everything was through Instagram. And then later on, if I want to work with some brand, I mail them. I send a mail with my media kit or something like that.
Okay. What are your plans for your future and where do you like see yourself in 5 years?
In 5 years? Okay, I'm already
yeah.
quite old now. It's like, so when I see myself in 5 years, I don't know, because dentistry is obviously there, because that is like my profession. I've studied in dentistry, I've studied dentistry and all. That's going to be there. But maybe, yeah, a little more, you know, professionalism, a little more work with fashion illustration as well, because I really like doing this, you can say. So maybe if that goes in a right way, but there is no plans as such that okay, I'll be doing only fashion illustrations or I'll be doing only dentistry as such.
Okay, so you're like going with the flow right now.
Yeah, going with the flow. Yes.
Okay. Next, Can you tell us the main, what's the main difference like between digital and handle illustration?
Hand illustrations is obviously more time consuming because everything is basically hand, and digital illustrations is like you can just, if you make a mistake also you can undo it, and that you cannot do with hand illustrations. So yeah, so you have to be very particular with hand illustrations. If you make a major mistake, you have to restart again. So obviously it takes a lot of time. But then hand illustration, you obviously now in the digital age also, in the digital illustration also, you can create an illustration that looks like hand illustration because of the new apps that have come. But that hand illustration always has some, the personality of the artist also. The person who is doing, that person's personality shows up in the hand illustration as well. So digital is a little bit more clean and more, it looks too clean sometimes.
Because there's no like chance space for mistakes there, and you see a mistake you can like immediately remove it, but with hand you have to, like,
Yeah.
it's always there are some mistakes.
Yeah. So when you
Okay.
have a lot of
Yeah.
yeah, so when you have like a lot of work to be done quickly, so then you can obviously go for digital illustrations. And nowadays, digital illustrations also can be given that effect of doing as a hand illustration.
Okay. So if you had to like describe your illustration style in three words, what words would you pick?
To be true, I don't think I've established a very particular style. But yeah, if I want to describe into three words, it's mostly feminine. And it's a bit of minimalism and minimalism, feminine, and I can say a bit of pretty things, like all it's not too rough and it's not too finished also. It's just a balance between both, like that, because I like the roughness of
Interesting.
some ha illustrations. That I do like that. I don't like a very complete clean image as well.
Okay. So you mostly work on hand illustration.
Yeah, but then now I have been doing digital as well. But when I do digital also, that is also through the Apple Pencil. So it's basically like a hand illustration, and I give the look of a hand illustration only. I don't give that
Okay, okay.
complete digital look.
Digital look. Okay. Okay, so okay, you would have worked with a lot of like brands and projects till now. Can you tell us which one was your best project and your best experience, and also what was your most terrifying experience till now?
So working with designers is usually sometimes easier because they give you the outfit and you have to illustrate that outfit. So you have everything in front of your eyes. You just have to illustrate that. So when I worked with Disha Patil Couture, Pret Couture, she had got a line of illustrations made from me. So that was pretty. I had used glitter in that. I had used watercolors in that to give that shine effect and everything. And it was all Indian costumes, Indian outfits. So that they were like very pretty thing to do. And I did work for a book, a romantic novel, romantic book, short stories, romantic short stories, where they needed illustrations. So that was a bit of difficult for me because I had to imagine the entire scene and create the entire scene in their form of an
On
illustration.
your own, yeah, like
Based on the story, I had to create an illustration that way.
okay,
That was a little
so
bit, yeah.
that was like difficult but not terrifying.
Not terrifying as such. Obviously, anything you do in the start, it's terrifying. Like, for example, today doing a live
Yeah.
is a terrifying job. Doing live, especially, a terrifying job because you can make mistakes when you're talking and everything.
Mistakes and you cannot edit anything.
Yes.
Okay, we've seen that during this quarantine you've been like putting up a lot of content on your page. Can you tell us how has quarantine and the whole lockdown situation affected your mental health and your both and your professional life?
When the quarantine started or when the lockdown started, so all of us were very unsure of what is going to go on and how we are going to do it. And we had to keep our dental clinics also closed for a very long period of time. So that is why that was the time I got a lot to paint. I got a lot of time for my art because as my workplace was closed, my clinic was closed for the 1 month at least. So I did get a lot of time in that, and I used to paint every day, and it was like all just painting every day and eating and sleeping. In the start, it was just that. But then even that led to a burnout in painting. But then I got back to it. Mentally, you are obviously tensed with all the sad news that you're hearing around. And since I stay alone in a house with my husband, I mean, I had to do all the house chores as well. So it became a little bit overwhelming in the start, where I used to do the house chores and then I used to not get, I used to be
There's
too,
everything at once, yeah.
it used to be too difficult to paint because I was tired doing the house chores. But then, yeah, I did get a lot of time to learn new techniques and new painting methods, which I wanted to learn, and I was not getting time earlier.
Okay, so overall, you would describe it as like a positive experience, like something
Yeah,
new.
it got slowed down a lot.
Also, okay.
Yeah.
And you were able to make time for something that you really like now.
Yes.
Okay. So, what would you like to say to people who want to like pursue their dreams? Because you're doing something very different and who are like afraid to face like struggles and rejection and how to face like difficulties in this field.
If you want to do something, just take it and do it. I mean, it's like you have to start somewhere. Unless you start, nothing is going to happen. So even when
Not
I,
like wait for anyone or anything.
yeah, that's what. So if you like something, you have to just start. Because whenever, when even I started this, it was not in my mind that I have to become a fashion illustrator or I will be doing this or something like that. I love painting, so I started painting. And then it was like eventually when you are into it, you start learning different things. You start learning different methods. You will be obviously rejected many times. I have been, whenever I want to work with a brand, I have mailed them and I have got no reply. It's like it's happened many times. But then you can't just take it to your heart. It's one day maybe they will come to you with something when they, it's that you want to show your presence there, basically. If you have your presence, and today in the world of social media, where Instagram has become such a big platform for artists and everyone, so you have to just be your presence if you want to get into it. Like today as well, when I do my dentistry and I do patients and all, so being that as a profession which pays the bills, I can say. So yeah, so that is obviously my first priority, but then I give that much time to this as well because this is what I love doing. So I love a lot doing, I can say that way. So just go there and just start with something, that's it.
Basically, you will eventually make time for something that you actually love doing.
Yeah. And you have
Okay, so
to go with it. Yeah, that's it.
okay. Any advice you think you'd like to give to aspiring fashion illustrator?
I'm not sure because I've not reached that level to give an advice, but yeah, I would say is that there are many, and nowadays I see many fashion students creating a lot of beautiful illustrations. But then I would just like to say is that especially today people are more worried about the followers on Instagram. And whether I'm getting work or whether how do I contact brands or something like that. But then if the work is not that established yet, the brands will obviously not be that. So it's like just paint and just try to improve your work how much you can, as much you try to learn different techniques, try to follow the work of fashion illustrators who have been doing this since longer period of time. See their work, see admired by them. And one thing I would like to say, which I have been seeing a lot now on Instagram, is that don't just directly copy somebody's work. Yeah, you are inspired by someone, It's fine, but don't take a screenshot and just copy someone's work, you know. That I
Yeah.
would.
So basically, instead of worrying about like the number of likes, followers, and comments, just focus on your work, and
Yes.
that's how you.
Yes.
Okay, that was a great way to put it. Okay, so enough with like the serious questions. Now we have like a fun rapid fire section planned. So
Okay.
what we'll do is I'll quickly ask you very one word answer or like choice based questions, and you have to answer them very quickly. Okay, I'll start.
Sure.
So, first one, hand done or digital?
Handed.
Okay. Illustrator or dentist?
I'm not sure. Maybe, you know, I can say artist, not an illustrator. Yeah, maybe artist.
Okay. Artist?
If I had an option earlier,
Okay.
maybe, yeah.
If you could have your illustrations on like cover of a magazine or work with a designer, which one would you pick?
Cover of a magazine, obviously being illustrating for Vogue is like a dream for any illustrator. So, already made many illustrations, imaginary illustrations for Vogue. And working with a designer in India, I would want to make designs for, make illustrations for Gaurav Gupta, whose gown we are going to paint today, because I love his gowns and
Oh.
everything. And even Amit Agrawal, even his, it suits my style of painting and it suits my, I mean, I am more into that kind of illustrations.
Okay, like more a little bit Indian with like all shiny, glittery stuff.
But not too detailed embroidery and not too detailed.
Yeah. Okay. So, yeah. Love to illustrate prints or solid color?
Solid colors anytime.
Solid color?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you think could ruin an entire illustration? Facial features or hands?
Facial features anytime. Facial features for me are very important.
Yeah, they're also very tricky to draw.
Yeah.
Okay, pastels or solid color?
pastels, little bit pastels.
Any quick drawing, illustrating tip?
Line drawing, basically making your draw, improving on your drawing is, and the anatomy is like one quick tip which I eventually learned, because unless you have the drawing nicely, how much ever good you paint, it doesn't come out that. And since, yeah, it's because it's a fashion illustration, it's not just a regular landscape or that, so you have to be very particular with the anatomy of the drawing for that.
Okay. Have you studied illustration or are you a self-taught artist?
No, I'm a self-taught artist. I've not done any professional course in this. Everything I've studied is through either some online courses or some books like
That's very cool, you know, done
that.
everything on your own.
Yeah.
Okay. Favorite medium to illustrate?
Watercolors. Watercolors
Watercolor?
are my favorite medium to illustrate anything.
Okay. Three most preferred fashion styles that you'd like to illustrate.
Fashion styles.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think I like a little bit of abstract as well as the minimalism style. So I am somewhere in between them. Not very realistic. I don't do very realistic. Yeah, I don't do very realistic as well. But it is you know, a midway between that.
Okay. Top five fashion illustrators you think people should follow?
Whom I follow, my inspire, I mean, admire a lot is, one is Jessica Durant. She is from Atlanta, USA. US. Her, I love her work. Then I also love the work of this travel, Megan Morrison, who has an art account page with travel draw and write, travel write and draw, or something like that. So she's one great one. And there's one art creation whose account I saw, and I started with my own illustrations. Her illustrations are very pretty, they are with nail polish. And since I love flowers, you will see a lot of flowers in my illustrations. Those are, I'm also inspired by Grace Chow. So in India, I also love the work of Anup Barua. He is quite a good illustrator. And so these are few illustrators whose work inspires me a lot.
Okay.
There are many others as well, but yeah, so these are some.
Okay. Monochromatic illustration or chromatic illustration?
Chromatic, yeah, I do all.
Chromatic. All-time favorite fashion designer?
I can say yeah, Gaurav Gupta maybe
Gaurav
all time, yeah.
Gupta. Most favorite patterns or garments you that you like to illustrate?
I usually like illustrating tulle, which is like which gives that romantic effect. Then I like illustrating flowers, and also like I like illustrating those gowns which have the romantic tulle effect. So that's couture made mostly
Like
is.
how you described that your style is very soft, feminine type,
Yes,
right?
yes,
Okay.
yes.
All-time favorite fashion illustrator, if you had to pick one.
Okay, there are two actually. There's one Jessica Durant, and yeah, and there's one. She's a like she's a German illustrator. Her name is Olga. And yeah, she has got a style which I like to do. And Jessica, because of her various mediums that she uses and her flow, how she gives that smooth flow every time.
Okay. Indian, you like illustrating Indian silhouette or Western silhouette?
That's a pretty tricky question. Actually, I like illustrating both. But then I illustrate more of Western because I don't have that much of time usually to give to the Indian silhouette. Indian silhouette takes a
Yeah,
lot of
with
time.
details and everything, it becomes
Yeah, details take a lot of time. So I, as since my style is more of a minimalism style, I go for the Westerns more.
okay. If you had to pick one Indian and one international designer that you'd like to collaborate with.
Indian, as I said, maybe Gaurav Gupta and Amit Agrawal, and Western Makisa, and and maybe any and it's always a dream to collaborate with Chanel or with Jimmy Choo, that's like always, yeah. So Makisa is one of
Okay,
my.
so yeah, because I can see, your choice. They have like all these designers have like a similar style and very similar silhouette.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're done with the rapid fire round. It
Yeah.
was great talking to you. I think did you like it?
Yeah, it
The
was fun.
rapid fire.
Yes, it was fun, and I've never answered so many regarding the I never answered so many questions regarding the illustration thing. So it was quite fun to do.
Thank you, Sneha.
Yeah, thank you. I'm looking forward to do the
All the
pilot
best.
of my robotic class.
Yeah, we're looking forward to watch it.
Yeah, sure. Anyway, chal. Bye.
Okay, thank you.